How can we conduct experiments using the scientific method? After watching this video, you can surely be a scientist. You will learn how scientists conduct experiments by using the scientific method in these 6 steps. Have you ever wondered how can scientists study our world? Scientists study our world using the scientific method. The steps needed to conduct experiments using the scientific method include making observations, asking a question, proposing a hypothesis, making a prediction, testing the hypothesis, drawing a conclusion, etc. If the conclusion supports the hypothesis, congratulations. But if it is not, we consider the hypothesis to be falsified, and thus we have to propose a revised or a new hypothesis. Sounds complicated? I will use an apple browning experiment as an example to explain to you. Let's first have a look at making observations. Scientists usually observe the things around them using the 5 senses. One of the examples of making observations is that after peeling, the apple turns brown very quickly. Try to find one daily example and observe around. Follow the steps in this tutorial and try to carry out an investigation. However, it is not recommended to perform any dangerous experiments without the presence of your teachers. Next step, asking a question. The questions are very powerful. It's good to ask questions while learning. This determines what will be investigated. Some good scientific questions might be why the apple turns brown after peeling its skin off. Next step, proposing a hypothesis. A hypothesis is a possible explanation of the question you raise and is testable. For example, we can complete experiments. For example, oxygen in air causes the browning of the apple can be a hypothesis. Carbon dioxide in air causes the browning of the apple can also act as the hypothesis. They are just possible explanations to answer your questions. That's somehow just a prediction. After that, to step number 4, predicting the expected results. For example, if you have the hypothesis, oxygen in air causes the browning of the apple, you can make a prediction that without the presence of oxygen, the apples won't turn brown. Step number 5, testing the hypothesis. This is the main part of the video on how to conduct a fair experiment. We can usually test the hypothesis by using experiments. For example, for the example of browning of apple, we can create a fair test to investigate whether the presence of apple will cause the browning of the apple. To test for the hypothesis, we will have to study its independent variable, dependent variable, and controlled variables. Independent variable is the variable that is purposely changed. Dependent variable is the variable that should be measured, while for controlled variables, it will be the variables that should be kept the same. In other words, dependent variables depends on the independent variable. In the case of the browning of the apple, the independent variable is the presence of oxygen. The dependent variable is the browning of the apple, and the controlled variables are the sizes of the apple cubes, etc. So, how can we design an experiment to prove our hypothesis of presence of oxygen causes the browning of apple? We can make the following setup. The cover prevents any other gases, including oxygen, from getting in setup A. Inside the beaker cupboard, there are only the types of gases except oxygen. This is basically the general idea. Now, as we know what are the independent variable, dependent variable, and the controlled variables, we need to see whether setup A or setup B is the control setup. In fact, a control setup can make sure the experiment to go fairly. The control setup should be the same as the experimental setup, only except that the independent variable is absent in the control setup. In our case, the presence of oxygen is the independent variable. Therefore, the control setup will be the setup without oxygen. And that will be, pause the video if you need more time. Setup A is the control setup because oxygen is absent, while for setup B, oxygen is present. That means the independent variable is present. As a result, it is experiment to set up A. Finally, drawing a conclusion. We can draw conclusions after the hypothesis is supported. If hypothesis is falsified with experimental results, we may form a revised hypothesis or a completely new hypothesis. For example, our hypothesis is that oxygen causes the browning of the apple. After completing the experiments, we can find out that the apple turns brown with the presence of oxygen, while without the presence of oxygen, the apple doesn't turn brown. Therefore, the experimental results support our hypothesis. Our conclusion is that oxygen causes the browning of the apple. Let's recap. Do you still remember the 6 important steps in conducting experiments? Let's see. Making observations, asking a question, proposing a hypothesis, making a prediction, testing the hypothesis, and drawing a conclusion. If the conclusion supports the hypothesis, congratulations. But if it is not, we consider the hypothesis to be falsified, and thus we have to propose a revised or a new hypothesis. Alright, so do you still remember the examples of the different steps? Let's have a look at this page. Let me turn it over to you. How would you design an experiment to investigate that the bats have to fly with the presence of hearing? Comments down below. Please, comment down below, subscribe to my channel, like the video, and share this video with your friends.